And for this I'm not fit for the task to craft words with adequate passion to match the size of grace beyond anything I could grasp, but it grabs hold of me, so I hold on tight and hug it back. Surrounded by grace that surpasses the past, beyond anything we could hope for or ask. How can words describe the word made flesh? The best way to understand him is to understand his death, what he set to accomplish and fulfilled with every step. He was sent from the Father, God's gift to the world, gave his only son to purchase sons and daughters, to make us one with the Son and one with the Father. Took upon himself the condemnation we deserved, resurrected after death, and he promised to return. Filled us with the Spirit to seal our election and protect us until the day that we share in his resurrection. The size of grace, how great the size, the gates of heaven are open wide, and people of all kind are welcome inside. Should have been denied, but instead God replied. He said, in your place my son has died. His death gave you life, it's the size of grace. Innocent blood that was shed to erase every trace of sin for a chosen race. It's the great exchange, it's power to change, the gospel salvation for all who believe, all for his glory. Overcoming our hatred and sin with his divine love.
The love of our God, gracious and kind, God became a man and suffered for mankind. The punishment for our sin was poured out on him, so we could be forgiven and forever live. Saved by grace, the cost was not cheap. We can't add to it, his work is complete. The greatest gift we could ever receive is the gospel salvation for all who believe.
So we pray for strength with the power of his Holy Spirit, so that Christ may dwell in our hearts through faith, that we would have the strength to comprehend, together with all the saints, the height, depth, and length, the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, filled with the fullness of God, the size of grace.